evening, everyone, and welcome. Thank you for your patience as we got some last-minute details straightened out here. I'm Kathy Nalivayko, president of the Ukrainian Institute of America. On behalf of our board of directors and members, I would like to thank all of you for joining us for this evening's Unity for Ukraine concert. We are extremely honored to host this very special evening in collaboration with our European neighbors and friends and cultural partners, all of whom are listed in your programs. If you don't have a program, raise your hand. Somebody's walking around with extra programs. While many of us have worked together in the past on joint programming, and the mic went, did it? No, okay. Since Putin's full-scale invasion of Ukraine more than 6 weeks ago, our relationships have grown much closer. The overwhelming support that each of the countries represented here this evening has shown toward Ukraine and towards us here at the Ukrainian Institute has been so consistent, so comforting, and so inspirational. Amongst these friends, where we are so wholeheartedly embraced, there is absolutely no question that Ukraine is European, that it belongs as an integral part of Europe, and that our homeland is a respected member of this community and has been for centuries, in spite of however many aggressors and regimes have desperately attempted to rewrite our history and erase our identity. These are incredibly difficult times for everyone, mostly for the people of Ukraine who are experiencing unspeakable horrors, and for the brave soldiers who are defending our homeland, and the ever-vigilant and inspiring President Zelensky, who is doing such an amazing job of fighting this war on all fronts, and the families that have lost loved ones, and the families that have been torn apart, and our diplomatic corps, thank you for coming, that is tirelessly advocating for Ukraine on the global stage. But it is also a very difficult time for the rest of us, who are witnessing this tragedy unfold in real time, nonstop, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We feel sad, scared, incredulous, horrified, angry, frustrated, and helpless, yet also hopeful and wholeheartedly inspired by the bravery of the Ukrainian people. This evening's concert brings together musicians and the diplomatic and cultural representatives from all over Europe to stand in solidarity with Ukraine, to raise funds for the people of Ukraine, and to provide hope and inspiration to those of us in the audience through the universal language of music. Evermore thanks to each of the individuals who are involved in this project for their time and expertise, and to all of the wonderful musicians for donating their time and talent toward this worthy cause. We have an amazing program for you tonight, so please get ready. Ukrainians everywhere are eternally grateful to the entire civilized global community for the unbelievable concern, support, and solidarity that everyone has shown for Ukraine and its people. We hope and pray that we can move toward peace quickly and start rebuilding our country. Thank you again to each and every one of you for being such amazing friends to us and to our homeland. Now, without further ado, I'll ask everyone to stand, first for the playing and singing of the Star-Spangled Banner, and then for the playing and singing of the Ukrainian National Anthem. Slava Ukraini.
Thank you. Vecher, good evening. I'm Solomie Vahi, violinist and artistic director of music at the Institute Concert Series here at the Ukrainian Institute of America. I would like to thank all of you for being here this evening. I also would like to express my gratitude to my fellow musicians and colleagues who are generously contributing their time and talents, and most importantly, showing their unity with the freedom-loving and determined people of Ukraine. Because of Ukraine's position in the center of Europe, its fertile soil and famous black earth, beautiful fields of wheat, poppy, corn, and sunflowers, and hard-working, friendly, and intelligent population, We are the builders of world's largest plane, Mria, and the birthplace of inventors Igor Sikorsky and Volodymyr Juice. By the way, thanks to Juice, we are gathered in this gorgeous building today. Ukraine has through centuries been seen as a prize to be won by invaders from every direction. For centuries, Ukraine has fought for democratic principles. The first European constitution was written in 1710 by Pilip Orlik, an exiled hetman of Ukraine, and the Ukrainian people have a long history of standing up for their freedom and sovereignty. At times, we have received help from our neighbors, but never like we are receiving today. We are so grateful to the international community of civilized and freedom-loving nations for standing with Ukraine. And your presence here tonight is a testament to your commitment and solidarity with Ukraine. Thank you. Дякую. We will begin this concert with Miroslav Skorek melody, Melodia, in A minor. This piece has become an unofficial second anthem of Ukraine and a symbol of resilience and courage of Ukrainian people. Thank you. teach this talented young man. And Eastern Ukraine was annexed by the Russian Empire at that time. In order for the composer to get a good education or to have a career, one had to be in Moscow or St. Petersburg. So Prokofiev moved to study there. I'm having a hard time agreeing that Prokofiev is a great Russian composer. Why? Serhii was born in Ukraine, lived in Paris for a long period until the Soviet government convinced him to come back, as they were going to make him a great Soviet composer. His music is more open, broad, and positive, and does not have a Russian voice. So I agree that he is great, but that he is also a great Ukrainian composer, so as are Berezovsky and Roslovets, the writer Gogol, and artists Malevich and Rabin, whom Russians have historically claimed as their own.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.